Hi students, I'm Sonia from Vidya Guru. We are starting a new session on current affairs. If you like the session, you can press the like button, share the video with your friends, and don't forget to subscribe to our channel. If you do that, I generally say that you will get benefited a lot, because a lot many questions whichever are there, as you can see, these questions are there on the board. They are very, very selective. We spend a lot of time to select such important questions. I'm starting from the very first question, and I would appreciate if you can watch the entire video. See, because if you do that, I feel at the end the revision is very important, and that revision will help you to retain the answers. We'll start from the very first question. That's Om Prakash Rawat. That's the name of our new Chief Election Commissioner. All right. The first question says India's new Chief Election Commissioner. So he is the new Chief Election Commissioner, and his name is Om Prakash Rawat. The name is important. Please understand that Om Prakash Rawat is the name of the person who has been appointed our new Chief Election Commissioner. The next question is Global Risk Report 2018 published by. This question automatically becomes important. The reason is, see, this report is published by World Economic Forum. The meet of World Economic Forum in Davos, Switzerland, attended by our Prime Minister Modi himself. World Economic Forum's meet, I'm referring to the meet of World Economic Forum in Davos, attended by many industrialists of India. Apart from that, Prime Minister Modi, he himself attended this meet. That is why this event of World Economic Forum automatically becomes important. I am saying Global Risk Report. If you want to know what's that, see, no question, no other question can be framed from this section. I feel that this is the important part. That is why I am teaching you. The important thing is, as the word risk is involved, that generates curiosity among students. I am saying Global Risk Report is about the world's economy has risk. And what sort of risks are they? They are going to talk about that. So we are not supposed to get into that sort of thing. I am saying Global Risk Report is published by World Economic Forum. That question is important, and you just need to keep only one thing in mind. The next question is richest state as per NFHS. What's that? National Family and Health Survey 4. According to that, the richest state is Delhi and the poorest state is Bihar. I'm writing it here. Poorest Bihar. That's the report by National Family and Health Survey 4. Don't forget this question. Richest state Delhi and the poorest state Bihar. The next question is about Filmfare Awards. Filmfare Awards. I am just going to tell you one thing. The question can be asked from this part as well. The movies of 2017. I am going to refer to the movies of 2017 because 2018 has just begun. So, the movies which were actually shown in 2017, the actors, the directors which were associated with those movies will get the awards in 2018. That means now. That is why Filmfare Awards are important. We'll start from the very first question, and that's the best film. Best film was given to Hindi medium. The direction is important. If I just tell you the name of the movie, that's less actually informative. I am going to tell you one more thing, that the direction of the movie was done by Saket Chaudhary. That's important. Don't forget the name. Going to repeat that. Filmfare Award 2018, best film was given to Hindi medium, which was directed by Saket Chaudhary. Filmfare Award 2018, best actor. See, all these questions are related. So, best actor was given to Irfan Khan. We all know Irfan. So, Irfan Khan for which movie? Irfan Khan for Hindi medium only. So, Irfan Khan got the award for best actor for Hindi medium. The next question is Filmfare Award 2018 best actress, which was given to Vidya Balan. Vidya Balan got this award for Tumhari Sulu. Vidya Balan got this award for Tumhari Sulu, where she was playing the part of a radio jockey. Vidya Balan got this award for Best Actress in the category of Best Actress. The next question is Best Director. Who got the Best Director Award? Best Director, Filmfare Award 2018, Best Director, the name of the person, Ashwini Iyer Tiwari. Ashwini Iyer Tiwari. That's the lady who got this award for Bareilly Ki Barfi. Ashwini Iyer Tiwari, Best Director, got the award for Bareilly Ki Barfi. Don't forget the name of the director. She is the Best Director. India's rank on World Economic Forum's Inclusive Development Index 2018. A lot many questions can be asked from this point. I am saying the one more thing which I actually wish to highlight apart from that. See, I'm going to break this index. How? That I'll tell you. Let's start from the very first question, which can be there in the exam. Inclusive Development Index is prepared by World Economic Forum. The first question, which is already there. But you have to keep this in mind. Inclusive Development Index is prepared by World Economic Forum. First question. The second question, I am going to tell you that India's rank, that's 62nd. Write it down. I'm going to rub it immediately. 62nd, that's the rank of India. India's rank on World Economic Forum's Inclusive Development Index, that's 62nd. Now you must be inquisitive to know who got the first rank in it. I'm going to explain that only. Let's write it down this way. 103 participating nations were there. 103 participating nations were there. The partition, as in the division, was like that. 74 emerging nations and 29 were the advanced nations. 74 were the emerging nations and 29 were the developed or advanced nations. So, as you can see, the number is higher here, that's 74. Obviously, they have to be emerging or developing sort of nations. So, among the emerging nations, Lithuania topped it. And when we say among these 29 advanced nations, Norway topped it. Going to write it here. Once again, World Economic Forum prepares Inclusive Development Index. So, Inclusive Development Index. India got the 62nd rank. I am saying nations were 103 in total. 74 were the emerging nations and 29 were the advanced nations. Out of advanced, Norway got the first rank, and out of emerging nations, Lithuania got the first rank. Don't forget that. The next question is, India's first coal to gas conversion plant location. See, if I talk about the location, that's Odisha. The location is Odisha. But I need to tell you one more thing, like who's going to place that plant over there? That's GAIL. G-A-I-L. You need to write both the things over there. Going to repeat that. India's first coal to gas conversion. When we are referring to gas, here it is synthetic gas. Coal to synthetic gas conversion plant is going to be there in Odisha, and GAIL is going to do that. G-A-I-L, GAIL is going to do that. HPCL's Barmer refinery is located in. Many people are familiar with the place Barmer already. So that is how they know that it is in Rajasthan. You'll ask a question, why is it important? I'm going to explain that too. First, you write it down. That's Rajasthan is the place. Rajasthan is the place where HPCL's Barmer refinery is located in. It came in news, and there's a reason. The reason was Pradhan Mantri Modi, Prime Minister Modi, was actually he was there. He went there. He inaugurated the commencement of work. He has inaugurated the commencement of work there in this refinery, of this refinery. That is why this question became important for us. HPCL's Barmer refinery is located in Rajasthan. That you need to know, and I told you that Mr. Modi was there. That is why this question even becomes important for us. He actually inaugurated the commencement of work of this refinery. Next question is, India's GDP growth rate estimate 2018-19 according to World Bank. World Bank has given the forecast. World Bank has, you know, given the forecast of the GDP of India. That was the last financial year, that was 2017-18, and that was 6.7%. In the last financial year, 17-18, the projection was 6.7%. Here it comes, that's 2018-19, the projection is 7.3%. I'm going to write it down here, that's the answer of our question. 7.3%, that's the projection. India's GDP growth rate estimate, please understand, that's just the forecast estimate. According, and that estimate is for the financial year 2018-19, according to World Bank, 7.3%. They are projecting it even for the further years as well. I am saying they are projecting it for other 2 years, that's 7.5%. India's GDP growth rate estimate for 2017-18 was 6.7 according to World Bank. For this financial year 2018-19, it is 7.3%, and they are projecting it even for the coming years too. For two coming years, they say that's going to be 7.5%. You need to write actually 3%. Government has declared 2018 as National Year of Millets. National Year of Millets. National Year of Millets. That's, government has declared 2018 was declared as National Year of Millets. The next question is, first Indian firm to cross, important, first Indian firm to cross 6 lakh crore market capitalization. 6 lakh crore market capitalization of more than 6 lakh crore. They've crossed that actually mark. For the first time it is happening. First Indian firm, important, first Indian firm to cross 6 lakh crore market capitalization. That's Reliance Industries Limited. I hope you are already familiar with this name. Reliance Industries Limited. They are already very famous. So first Indian firm to cross that mark. 6 lakh crore. The next question is, Women's T20 World Cup 2018 venue. West Indies is the place where it is determined that it is going to happen. What? Women's T20 World Cup. So, Women's T20 World Cup will take place in West Indies. The next question is, initiative for strengthening cyber security. We all know what sort of cyber security is there. Just to strengthen that, our government has launched Cyber Surakshit Bharat Yojana. If it is written that way, Cyber Security Bharat Initiative, even that can be there, the name of the same thing. I am saying it is actually famous as Cyber Surakshit Bharat Yojana. You need to know that it can be called Cyber Surakshit Bharat Initiative also. Let's start the revision. Om Prakash Rawat has become the new Chief Election Commissioner. World Economic Forum prepares Global Risk Report. Delhi, the richest state, and the poorest state, Bihar, according to National Family and Health Survey 4. Best film in Filmfare Awards, Hindi medium, directed by Saket Chaudhary. Best actor, Irfan Khan for Hindi medium. Tumhari Sulu, Vidya Balan got best actress. Best director, Ashwini Ayyar Tiwari for Bareilly Ki Barfi. And India's rank on World Economic Forum's Inclusive Development Index, that was 62nd. India's first coal to synthetic gas conversion plant, location, Odisha, and the plant will be actually placed over there by GAIL. HPCL's Barmer refinery is located in Rajasthan. Projection report, as in they are projecting GDP of India, as in growth rate of the GDP of India for 2018-19, that's 7.3 according to the World Bank. Government has declared 2018 as National Year of Millets. Reliance Industries Limited, the first Indian firm to cross the mark of 6 lakh CR crores market capitalization. Women's T20 World Cup 2018 will be held in West Indies. Initiative for strengthening cyber security, Cyber Surakshit Bharat initiative. We are wrapping it up. Thank